Nice, let's get it going fast. Alex mentioned something about the N-word, and white people have a fascination with wanting to say it but never saying it for fear of getting their ass kicked. So I thought of like this cute little joke I wanted to tell before I really get into it. What starts with an N and ends with an R, and black people hate being called this? Naysayer. Everybody hates being called naysayer. I mean, everybody probably thought I meant navigator, but no. Black people are great at navigating, just saying. So I went to Moe's the other day. You guys know Moe's Southwestern, right? Great food. Everybody clap if you know Moe's. So I went into Moe's, and they were like, "Welcome to Moe's, faggot." And I was like, "What?" That was just a story. That wasn't a joke. I'm just saying. So, you guys heard about bath salts yet? Like, back in the day, people just used to smoke pot to get high. But now, like, we've run out of things to get high upon. So they've resorted to smoking bath salts. And I don't know if any of you guys have heard of the horrible side effects of bath salts. But people mutilate themselves. They cut themselves up. One dude in Pennsylvania cut his dick off. Yes, he cut his dick off. There is nothing that would make me cut my dick off. Could you imagine what he saw? Just like, just, can you imagine that? The terror, the fear in his eyes to just sniff it. Or was he just like, oh, fuck, hey, whoa. God damn. I just cut my penis off because I'm high on bath salts. Wowzer. Okay. Anyways, so... I mean, I love weed, but you know what I hate? I hate fucking people who are always like, let's smoke a blunt. Oh, dude. First off, I'm white. I can't roll a blunt. Sorry, dude, you know, it's just like, this smokes like shit. You rolled up shit in a cigarillo and you fucking passed it to me. Nothing's happening. Secondly, if you smoke really good weed, rolling a blunt is like smoking 5 packs of cigarettes in like fucking 10 minutes. You don't do that shit. You do not. You don't smoke fucking 5 packs of cigarettes, alright? And if anybody's saying that they're getting really good weed for 40 and 8, fuck you, because that's a lie. Chapel Hill, Durham, Raw, you pay fucking $60 to $80 an eighth. I'm just saying, I don't sell, but I fucking buy a lot of weed. Alright? I'm just saying. Moving on. You know, here's a dilemma, guys. Here's a dilemma. It's a dilemma when you're a straight guy and you go to your parents and you have, or your friends, anybody who you fucking know, and you gotta tell them, hey, I have AIDS. That's only if you're a heterosexual guy, that's a dilemma. It's a fucking crisis if you're a gay guy and you have to tell your parents you have AIDS. You know why? Because you're basically telling your parents, yeah, I got fucked in the ass. That's awkward. And if it's not that, you're like, yeah, I got AIDS because I sucked dick. Your dad's just like, fuck. It's like, Dad, you're on for a cigarette. You haven't smoked in 14 years. You know what I mean? You're basically telling your parents you have AIDS in your butt. You're like, I got AIDS in my butt, and there's no fucking reversing that shit. That's like a diamond. It's forever. You know what I mean? I'm just saying, guys. I don't know even what we're at here. Can I keep going? I got two minutes. You know they made a prequel to Brokeback Mountain called Deliverance? Have you guys seen that fucking movie? There are like 2 parts of that whole movie. One where those guys are like playing banjo and the white dude gets lost. And 2, where the guy gets fucking raped! He gets raped! That is the most unrealistic movie in the entire fucking world. Let me tell you why. Because if you put a shotgun to my chest and you said, squeal like a pig, boy, I'm about to rape your butthole, I would say, shoot me, motherfucker! Shoot me! Just rape that 12-gauge hole in my stomach. Because I really think the whole point is for me to be alive. So, whatever. You know, you're not going to rape this guy, alright? It's not going to happen. Are any of you guys the kind of person in this room who finishes a sentence when somebody's talking? Like, most people do it in their head, but I do it aloud. If you're going to say, hey, exactly, Rachel. It's like, I'm going to the store, I need Vicks vapor, and they're like, rub. You say it out loud, rub, I need rub. So I was in the club, right? We're in the club dancing, you know, where's that gay guy, you know, we're just dancing, doing our moves. And dude, a fight erupts in the middle of the club. No bullshit, fight erupts. It's two black dudes, don't know why I'm saying that. I just remember clearly two black guys. Intimidated. So, the naysayers, those fucking naysayers. So, we're in the club, right? And it's like, dude, it just slows down, right? The one guy goes, hey man, that's my girl. And the other dude's like, fuck you. And I'm like, in the butt! And like, dude, it's like, you know, you say something like that, and the music's like, I'm like, in the butt! Dude, it's like, mother, just like, what the fuck did this white boy just say? And she's like, I'm fucking out of here. Yeah. Don't know how this thing works. I think we gotta put some hair on it, you know what I'm saying? But in closing, guys, remember, ladies, your infant needs to have their eyes on the nipple when breastfeeding. That's my set. Everybody have a wonderful fucking evening. They need to have their eyes on the nipple when they're breastfeeding. They latch on. No, it's for women. No, the infants need to have their eyes on your breast when they're breastfeeding.
I know y'all have a discussion about breastfeeding.